Well, since 2010, young Indigenous men and women from all parts of the country have been selected to push themselves further than they ever thought possible. The Indigenous Marathon Foundation continues to inspire every year by training people with very little experience to become marathon runners. But as Kris Flanders reports, the organisation has done so much more than that.
This is Layne Brown, and this time this weekend, the scenery will look a lot different than crossing the Lake Illawarra entrance between Windang and Warilla on the New South Wales south coast. Layne is one of 12 runners in this year's Indigenous Marathon Foundation's journey to take part in the New York Marathon.
Running is like the one constant in my life at the moment. It's so reliable, like I can be stressed out, but although sometimes tough, you know what you're going to get. You know, you go and do it, you get the work done, and you feel good afterwards. Personally, I've learned that I'm capable of achieving much more than I ever thought was possible.
He says long distance running is hard, but it's not as hard as living with the chronic diseases that continue to affect the lives of Indigenous Australians. Even Layne had to curb his own lifestyle to make the most of the opportunity to be involved with the Indigenous Marathon Foundation.
For me, you know, I lived a lot of years eating junk food, drinking like a fair bit of alcohol, and it took real courage to want to make a change. If you stay in your comfort zone for too long, nothing's going to change. You know, everything's going to stay the same. And if you want to be that catalyst for change within your family, like, you can be that. You can give up the smokes or whatever it is. You can give up the grog or the coffee or the gambling. You know, everyone's got their different vices.
Since joining the IMF ranks in February this year, he's dropped over 20 kilograms and running has become part of his daily routine. He's also inspiring others to think about their health.
I just started running a local runners and walkers group in the Illawarra. We actually launched it in two locations. They're not training for a marathon, they're training for fitness. They're training for life. I've got my uncle and my father who come down to actually where we are today, and they go for a walk, and I've never known those two ever to go for a walk together, and that's facilitated by me in trying to build a better life together rather than on their own.
World champion marathon runner Rob De Castella is an Australian sporting legend. 2017 will be the eighth time that the champion runner has guided Indigenous men and women to compete in New York under the IMF banner. Former squad member from 2014, Adrian Dodson-Shaw, has taken over the reins as head coach.
Just something about him from the start, like meeting the first thing and first impression about, you know, what his purpose and what his drive was, and then for me to try out and do the 5K and then to sit down and have a yarn to me, and I could just see something in him so special. You know, there's a lot of things that he's done in through his life, and there's a lot of things that he hasn't finished, so this is something that he has started, and now he's going to finish this.
Having our coach, who not only was, you know, a grad, so he ran the marathon, but also has a family and was made it extremely relatable for us. So I think the squad's really taken that on board. You know, his leadership is like, you know, it's not about what we say we do, like we do it, like we show people.
First run in 1970, the New York Marathon gets underway this weekend and is the largest marathon in the world. Starting from Staten Island, it goes through Brooklyn before crossing the Queensboro Bridge, taking in the Bronx and Harlem before crossing the finish line in Central Park. It's a long way from the streets of the Illawarra region for this proud Yuin man.
It'll mostly be a battle with myself. I mentioned earlier I struggled with weight, and I've been overweight and other things, and I've lived in a way that wasn't real good for my body. For me, this is a real test to see if I can overcome and beat that person that I was for so long. And that 42Ks is going to individually break every single one of us down, and by the end of it, we're going to come out a different person.
The race in the Big Apple will be the first time that Layne and his IMF teammates have run the full marathon distance of just over 42 kilometres.
I feel confident and strong because I know I've done the training, I've put in the work, and running's really simple, it's really honest. You know, if you do the work, you can get the result. So I feel really good about it. I'll be more than likely the slowest runner on the day, but I know that, you know, in my brain that I think I'm gonna get it done.
Layne speaks highly of his fellow runners and says they will represent their communities and all Aboriginal and Torres Strait Islander peoples with distinction in America.
I've grown up in a pretty big Aboriginal community, but to find, you know, 12 other people who are motivated, switched on and wanting to do good things in their lives was really crazy. So all of a sudden you've just met all these people now. They're like your own brothers and sisters now, you know, in wherever, Cairns, Alice Springs, Broome, Perth. So it's just been, for me, incredible to meet these other Aboriginal people that are wanting to do things within their own worlds.